Buddhist. Buddhist party.
Hello, this is the RPG Chick. Welcome to Let's Play Star Trek Borg. Pardon me, my voice is still a little messed up. I had a cold like 2 weeks ago and it's still rather messed up. My apologies for the hiss on the microphone. Couldn't be avoided. It's the only way I can record with Cam Studio. I can't record this with Fraps. I'm running Windows 95 in VirtualBox, which is a virtual machine, so I'm running Windows 95 within Windows 7, basically. Star Trek Borg was released in 1996 by Simon & Schuster. It's a FMV, full motion video game. I'm playing this blind, and I am playing this commentated, so... Sorry, I keep clearing my throat. Well, the alternative is to not do Let's Plays for, I don't know, a month or something? How long will it take my voice to get back to normal? So, without further ado, this should be pretty fun. You can't play this without, you can't play it other than in Windows 95 or with a patch in Windows 98. Some people have reported saying they got it working in Windows XP, but I can't confirm that, and other people said they've been unable to do it, so I'm pausing. You might not be able to see these stars at all, but as of now, there are stars.
Priority message, USS Canale to USS Cheyenne. We are under attack by Borg forces. Repeat, Borg forces. We intercepted two Borg vessels heading on a direct course for Sector 001. Search this signal is 2 weeks. Have an order to warn Starfleet Command. If you can read us, do not, repeat, do not send help. We are lost. Warn Starfleet. The Borg have returned. Repeat, the Borg have returned.
Ta-da! So this plays out like a Star Trek Next Generation episode, only from your point of view. There's Q! Hooray! He's hilarious. I recognize Terry Potts' name. I've seen the beginning of this, you know, just testing out.
0730 means 0730, cadet. Sit down.
Which means 7:30 in the morning?
First,
too early.
The captain wanted me to convey his regrets for not being here himself. As I'm sure you've heard, Starfleet is amassing an armada in Sector 001 to defend against the latest Borg incursion. Our ship is on her way to join them.
Mm-hmm.
Starfleet has successfully defeated the Borg twice before, and we have every expectation of successfully stopping them now. However, given the probability of armed conflict, the captain has ordered that all non-essential personnel, including visiting Starfleet cadets, be transferred off the ship to a safer venue at the medical research facility on Marnus 3.
Wah, wah.
Please have your gear packed and be at Shuttle Bay 3 in 30 minutes. Dismissed.
That was the bad news.
Cadet Furlong.
Yeah, our name's Furlong.
A moment, please.
Like Edward Furlong?
The captain has denied your request to stay on board, Cadet.
Hey.
I'm sorry.
How dare he?
The massacre 10 years ago at Wolf 359 was a great tragedy for the Federation. I was only 1 year out of the Academy when it happened. A lot of my classmates died there. Now, each year I get older and they stay the same. I understand your need for justice. I'm sorry.
Revenge!
Shuttle Bay 3 in 30 minutes.
How dare you dismiss me like that. So she's referring to Wolf 359, the events which occurred at the, in the Best of Both Worlds two-part episode. Star Trek Next Generation. I think this is the only time you get to see yourself, the character you're playing.
Temper, temper, young man. What would your father say?
Who the hell was that?
How old were you
Q.
when your father was killed? 9, 10 years old? And you're still not over it? Perhaps I should introduce myself. I imagine you've heard of me, though. Q. It's short for Q. It was I, you know, who introduced Picard to the Borg. And it's because of me that 10 years ago the Borg came to Wolf 359 and found that fleet of ships and found your father and killed them all.
Yeah, so we should attack him now.
At 0800 hours during the Battle of Wolf 359, the USS Righteous, such a noble name, Righteous, was hit by an unknown Borg weapons discharge and vaporized. Vaporized.
Yeah, rub it in.
Nothing to bury, nothing to mourn. The Borg took it all away from you in an instant. I understand your desire for justice. They don't, though, do they? But I do. You want action. You want to avenge your father's death. You want to kill Borg. What sentient, yet still barbaric bipedal hominid wouldn't. You can run away with the others like a scared trog, or you can come with me, cadet. The choice is yours.
Well, he just admitted before that it's his fault. This is a little Borg cube, if you can see that. Now, if you don't do anything...
Maybe you didn't hear me. I'm offering you a chance to go and kill some Borg. Do you want to or not?
Now, normally you would click on the luggage or the suitcase... Well, the gun. But...
Maybe you didn't hear me. I'm offering you a chance to go and kill some Borg. Do you want to or not?
I know, I think one more time. Because this is really funny. Yeah, here we go.
What is this? The first time you've used a computer? You see this? It's a cursor. Use it to click on objects on the screen. Here, click on me.
And if we don't?
You've had your chance.
Bye. Game over.
Good. Okay, let's try again.
Okay, so if we click on this...
It looks like I misjudged you. You're only interested in saving your own skin. And to think I went to so much trouble to arrange it all.
Come on, cadet, you're... Q, intruder alert, deck 6.
Don't even bother.
Okay, so we'll do it right this time. Give me that.
Excellent choice, monsieur. Keep the phaser, you're going to need it. And take this too. Be careful now, don't lose it. I only made one.
Give me that.
Time!
0758.
Okay, now if we... now they gave us this thing. See the way it circles like that? When it stops, you can analyze.
Q. Member of the Q continuum. Omnipotent. Immortal. And an all-around swell guy. Capable of being and doing, well, pretty much whatever I want. It's good to be a Q.
Alright, so how do I get out of that again? Exit?
Q. Member of the...
Okay.
Captain Nikolai Andropov. Human of Greca Colony, Academy class of 40. First Greca colonist to graduate from Starfleet Academy. Stationed aboard USS Righteous as first officer, stardate 35777. Field promotion to captain, stardate 36533, by Admiral Santana. During the conflict at Kikiri 2, accomplished Sunni sound manipulator player.
Sunni sound manipulator player?
Ensign Anastasia Targus, human, Academy class of 51, currently stationed aboard the USS Righteous,
Targus received medical discharge as per Section Alpha 8. That means she was nuts. Stardate 42112, when judged mentally unfit as a result of her capture and torture experience at the hands of the Cardassian Obsidian Order.
Ooh. Cardassians.
Sounds pain. Reinstated after a year and a half of enforced medical leave, Stardate 43616, due to vociferous petitioning by Lieutenant Ralph Furlong and Lieutenant Corus Sprint.
Oh. So I was one of the people who petitioned to have her return to active duty. About this person.
Lieutenant Ralph Furlong, human, Academy class of...
That's myself.
Stationed aboard the USS Righteous, Stardate 40559. As a cadet, he was the recipient of the Federation Medal of Valor for his part in the rescue of hostages during a Cardassian raid on a Starfleet outpost, Stardate 42029.
Alright, so there's another point where you get to see yourself. I got some
Lieutenant
detail.
Commander Bennington Ben Baraka, human. Starfleet Medical Class of 47. Ship's counselor for the USS Righteous. In addition, holds qualifying ratings in four command line positions. Security, ops, navigation, and tactical. Counselor Baraka was part of the medical team which developed a successful treatment for the hostages from the Cardassian raids of 65, who had been subjected to neurostim torture. Winner of a silver medal in low-gravity equestrian jumping at the Federation Olympics. Stardate 37082.
Okay. Having trouble here.
During a rash of raids by Cardassians on non-military outposts and settlements in 2365, numerous Federation civilians and cadets were captured by the Cardassians. The hostages were often subjected to neurostimulation torture.
Ouchie.
The stimulation, pleasurable in the extreme, was
really
also profoundly addictive. Once a prisoner was neurologically dependent, stimulation was withheld until the Cardassians got the information they wanted. Pleasant lot, those guys.
You really, they wait until you're hooked on it, and then...
Cardassians. Humanoid race that has been involved in a bitter, extended conflict with the United Federation of Planets. An uneasy truce between the two adversaries was finally reached in 2366. Sound like the Klingons. But far...
Yeah, really.
Bajani. Humanoid. Planet of origin, Bajan. After the destruction of Bajan by a planetary cataclysm, the Bajani became a nomadic space culture for nearly two millennia, until the discovery of Bajan 2. For the past 300 years, the Bajani have remade the barren Bajan 2 into a near replica of their original home. The Bajani possess a unique psychophysical response, sometimes referred to as a Bajani pain trance. In the face of great pain or trauma, a Bajani compartmentalizes his mental patterns, storing most of his higher consciousness in a protected area of the Bajani brain, called the Langstrom cortex. During a period of crisis, this phenomena allows a Bajani to complete a complex physical task free from the awareness of pain or fear, and unencumbered from their so-called consciousness. Hmm. The Bajani pain trance is generally induced by a natural production of adrenaline in response to some physical trauma. This condition may be prevented or reversed by the introduction of an adrenaline block into the Bajani system.
Yeah, interesting. Oh, what do I have to say about the Borg themselves?
Borg, an extremely powerful, cybernetically enhanced species of humanoids. Planet of origin, unknown. First encountered, Stardate 42761.3, when the USS Enterprise was transported deep into the Delta Quadrant during a hostile encounter with a member of the Q Continuum. Hostile, indeed. Bunch of babies.
So it's worth it to hear this, in my opinion. What does he have to say about humans?
Humans. Terrans. Planet of origin? Earth. Members of the Terran species have populated vast areas of the Alpha Quadrant, developing new and sometimes completely isolated planetary cultures. These various Terrans constitute a major contingent of the Federation. Humankind is admired among species of the Federation for the speed with which its Earth-native culture progressed from a pre-industrial to a warped society. Humans are also admired for their insatiable intellectual curiosity.
He knew he was going to say something at the end. Klingons?
Klingons. Planet of origin known by many names.
Microbrain?
Officially referred to by the Klingon High Command merely as the Klingon home world. Humanoid warrior species of great physical strength with a complex culture of rituals and ranking. Once considered a major threat to the Federation, presently, at least in this present, an uneasy and tenuous alliance exists between the Klingon Empire and the Federation. The driving force of the Klingon culture is honor, making them a species which is both feared and respected throughout the galaxy.
Like he couldn't believe what he was reading. And Vulcans.
Vulcan. Oh, please, everybody knows about Vulcans. Dull, logical, unemotional, cousins to the Romulans. And I hope you're not going to ask me to tell you about them, because I won't.
Oh, he didn't even read it. Okay, hopefully you guys can read that if you want to. Did I look at this guy here?
Dr. Thaddeus Quint, human. Starfleet Medical Class of 49. Chief Medical Officer of the USS Righteous. Personnel file contains numerous personal letters of commendation, mixed with a significant number of incidents of crew conflict.
You can tell me about the Righteous.
USS Righteous Schematic. A general visual overview of the USS Righteous. Key areas such as bridge, crew quarters, engineering, computer core control, are highlighted. More information is available on all areas, including turbo lift designation codes.
Okay. How do I get out of this?
Sir, keep those phasers firing, and where are my photon torpedoes?
Armed and ready, Captain.
Have a look. I can't see you.
Let's see if we can shake them up a little, Ensign.
Initiating Delta attack, sir.
I'm reading a small weakness in the shields.
Shields are holding fine, but power is down 10%. Weapons having no effect.
Damn.
So this is us.
Just their shields already.
Why is it always the difficult species that are the most adaptable?
The Borg adapt their environment to suit their needs. True adaptability involves changing oneself to suit their environment.
I'm so glad you cleared that up.
Recognize this place? You should, to keep a picture of it on your wall. The bridge of the USS Righteous. Your father's ship.
The Tolstoy just took a major hit.
This is him, isn't it? Well, I can see the family resemblance.
Oh, that's not me, that's my father.
The Kyushu's coming on strong. Melbourne and Saratoga have lost power.
Tolstoy, Kyushu, Saratoga, Melbourne. Recognize the names? Do you know where you are, cadet?
The Melbourne, yeah.
Intruder
I remember hearing about that. Here's the Borg.
Security, isolate the ops console now.
That's right, 10 years ago, Wolf 359.
Security!
Yep. There's a big massacre
Look,
there.
He's barely older than you are. He shouldn't be in security, but 4 hours ago, the real security officer, Lieutenant Sprint, was killed, and this first-year ensign had to take his place. And because of his inexperience, everybody on board, including your father, will be killed. The phases are useless. Just isolate the panel now. If Lieutenant Sprint were still alive, he might be able to save the ship. But he's been dead for 4 hours. No wonder they don't want him on the bridge.
Come on, can't you move faster?
Chief Medical Officer Dr. Thaddeus Quint. He actually tried to save Sprint's life, but as you can see, he failed, the old goat. Well, what'd you expect? He's a doctor, not a security officer.
Okay.
Still, if he had only had a little more creativity. But he didn't.
He's bypassed the security lockout.
Down he goes.
Doctor. He's dead.
Whoops.
Shield mutation is shifting on its own. Shields are dropping.
Uh-oh. I need shields back up now.
Death in battle. If it were a Klingon, he'd be ecstatic.
Ooh, I like this guy.
Captain, there's a Type Beam transmission going directly to the Borg cube.
Computer is uploading data about emergency transporters.
Anyone near Jeffrey 6, we need manual power rerouted through the secondary couplings.
It's too late. The Borg cube is firing.
That doesn't look like it should have killed him.
So, now that you've seen your father die, are you ready to avenge his death? Or would you like to try something different? How about a chance to prevent his death? Lieutenant Sprint was killed 4 hours before the Righteous even got to Wolf 359. But if the good Dr. Quint had been able to save Sprint 4 hours before, then Sprint would have been able to save the Righteous, and you would have grown up in the loving company of your father, and all for the want of a horseshoe nail. What say we give the old goat a second chance to save Sprint's life? You're not afraid of a little space-time continuum meddling, are you, Cadet?
What sayest thou?
No, I thought not. Shall we? This is Lieutenant Sprint. Do you think he knows he's gonna die?
I don't think so. Don't bother saying hello. Just makes saying goodbye that much harder.
Time, Mr. Furlong? Oh, 400 hours, sir.
Cube within sensor range yet?
Coming up now, Captain.
Match speed, stay with it.
Setting a pursuit course.
Shields up.
Intruder alert.
Sprint, look out!
Shall we dance?
Come on, Sprint, make a choice.
Not sure what I'm doing here.
Boom. Oh, now that was clever. I turned you into Lieutenant Sprint, so I could be Quint and save you. Him. You. Whatever.
Sprint
so
and
that
Quint?
You could save the Righteous. And then you go and you get yourself killed anyway. I mean, really, it's not worth meddling with the timeline if you're just going to make things worse. I hope you're not one of those passive contemplatives. Try again.
All right, guys, we're going to stop here. Thanks for watching. Tune back next time. I am having a little trouble. The mouse pointer is not... Well, it's hard to explain. My pointer in Windows, when I'm moving my mouse, is not equaling where the little Borg cube goes. So I'm having trouble moving the cube to where I want it to be. So that's what's going on here. And yeah, other than that, that's about it. Thanks for watching and see you next time. And this is Nord Pudding.